Describe the world's best dressed crab.
I'm going to say a little bit of lime, some chilli, some mayo, and then just, yeah, serve with, like, brown bread, probably.
That does sound delicious.
Sounds good, doesn't
it? Yeah, but I'm actually talking about a live crab.
You didn't say that.
No, I didn't.
I should be clearer.
A lot of the things you said tonight have been ambiguous.
Yes. Welcome to the show.
Is it in a shell suit?
I'm proud to be your friend. No. There's something called a dresser crab, or indeed the decorator crab, and what it does is it gathers material from all around itself in order to blend in with the surroundings. So it's basically making camouflage clothing. They cover their shells in seaweed, in sponge and pearls, chewing on the material in order to make it fibrous, and then it attaches it to itself. It's got, like, little tiny Velcro bits on its claws and legs. I love this one is seriously getting dressed up.
On a Saturday night, that is. That's proper getting ready.
And they're found off the coast of Australia. They're tiny, just over 1.5 inches. And sometimes what they do is they put noxious stuff on them to ward off predators. It's called aposematism.
It's called lynx. Other sprays are available.
But there are lots of what we call augmented animals, so animals who make themselves look a bit different. One of my favourites, Rubber Lugan's caterpillar. It keeps its old heads and wears them as hats.
Oh, my God! That is hoarding gone mad.
As it grows, it sheds its exoskeleton and the protrusion on the top of the head remains, and eventually it has a stack which it uses both as a weapon and as a false target for any would-be predators. It's known as the mad caterpillar.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Found in Australia and New Zealand, isn't it wonderful?
That's incredible. Mm.
He doesn't even need that. Look how much you'd remember him anyway.
Yeah. You know the one? Do you remember the guy you met him last week? He had five heads on his five heads as a hat.
Five head Gary, yeah.
Yeah.
There's another one which is a beetle that lives in the Costa Rican rainforest. It's called Nymphster crenari, and it disguises itself as an army ant's bottom. So that looks like it's just an ant, but the bit that is a protrusion, as if the ant has got terrible hemorrhoids, is actually a beetle. And what it does is it bites onto the ant and then it rides around disguised as an army ant's bottom.
What a life.
What a life. Yeah.
Do you think the ant knows what's happening? Why it's got an extra bum? Or do you think the ant is like, oh my God, the piles are back?
Yeah.
Well, it'll keep going like that, wouldn't it?
Yeah. What the hell is that?
I'm sure there's something.
Suddenly you're the Kim Kardashian.
Oh, no, no. You never see me. Every now and then it goes, doo 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 doo. I can hear something. But then the ant will shit in its face. Oh, you ruined it! You were behind me, you shitty beetle!
All the other ants are going, you haven't put on any weight, you look fine.
Really?
Are you sure? You look fine.
And then the five-head caterpillar goes, have you seen him? He's hanging onto his arse. Well, you can't possibly be living down here.